with elders in our communities. We learn about the roots of things. We learn about where things come from. We learn about some really beautiful things. We learn about some really hard things too. And the more I spent time with my grandma, she explained to me, well, I made food that way because that's how my mom taught me. That's how her mom taught her, that if we were going to take a trip, we didn't know how many places we'd go that were safe to stop. We didn't know how many counters we'd stop where we would actually be served. Or how many places we'd go and they'd say, well, we'll serve you, but you gotta walk around the back to be served. So we made those boxes of food. So we knew our family would have something to eat. And I thought about my grandma and all those stories, all those things in our roots. Sometimes you're gonna study your roots, you're gonna study history, you're gonna study the people you come from, and you're gonna discover so much beauty. And sometimes you're gonna discover some hard and ugly things. But a part of why we have to study our roots and know the places our heritage comes from is because when we see the wrong things, I think God gives us a chance in the present to make some of those wrongs right.
Joshua, do not be afraid. Be strong and courageous when you lead and work, when you care and love, when you write, speak, create, when you have to wait. And I had this opportunity to perform a spoken word at a worship event. And I went there and I did this poem that I've written about God. I remember after that, there was this little stairwell that you had to walk down in order to get back out into the sanctuary. And I sat down on those steps. And I just felt God saying to my soul, I felt God saying to me, this is my gift. It doesn't belong to you. It's not for people to know who you are. It's not for you to be famous or for you to do anything with it. It is my gift and it is for me to shine. You be careful what you do with the gift. And I want to charge that to you, whatever your role is here in this beautiful community of Chowan. I want you to think about the gift that God has given you. How can you take that gift and honor God with it?
So I can see my family history in a stitch. And every time my grandmother speaks, I realize that words have roots. They're kind of like trees, but mostly like seeds who you groom and raise. You hope you plant them well, that from the ground receive them, that someday somebody will take them home, call them their own, they will find a place to belong. And words keep encouraging me to dream, keep reminding me that God listens when I sing. And that's how I know this is real, and I am still shaking.
I don't want to tell you that a lot of people will do horrible things, and they will stamp the name of Jesus on those things. They will say terrible things, and they will tell you that Jesus said it was okay. I want to tell you, don't just read the press release of Jesus. Don't just read the stuff that other people say Jesus is or that Jesus is about. You get to know who Jesus is for yourself. Healing than we are. God's better at the doing and the fixing than we are. The best thing you can do is be still, be quiet, and let God do His work.